Hi, this is Gabriela Ortiz for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to show you how you can embed Stata results and graphs in Word documents. With the putdocx suite, you can create Word documents with tables of estimation results and summary statistics, as well as graphs created in Stata. And you can easily insert large blocks of text to elaborate on these results. Not only can you easily embed Stata results into a Word document, you can also customize the layout of your document. You can create a Word document with a title, subtitle, headings, and headers and footers with page numbers. You can even organize your document into different sections and modify the layout, header, and footer for each section. All of these capabilities allow you to create a complete report right within Stata. But the putdocx suite is also very flexible. You can append multiple files and control how page breaks, headers, and footers appear in the appended document. And if you are building your report from multiple files, you can also insert text files with pre-formatted text in your document. You might even interact Stata's capabilities with Word's additional formatting features. Once you've exported your results to a Word document, you can continue formatting your document in Word. Now that you know the capabilities of the putdocx suite, we can move on to the fun part where I'll show you how it works. First, I'll create a basic report and then I'll demonstrate how you can customize it. I want to create a report on infant birth weights using the following data from Hosmer and Lemeshow. So I have put together the following do file. The version command at the top allows me to recreate this document in any future version of Stata. And the first thing we need to do is create a document in memory with putdocx begin. This creates a letter-sized document with pages in portrait orientation. We can specify a different page size, layout, and font format for the document, but we'll stick with the default to keep it simple. Next, we add a title for this report. First, by adding a paragraph and specifying the title style, and then adding the text of the title. After that, I want to add a description of the data. Here, we could have used putdocx paragraph and putdocx text as we did above, but to add a large amount of text, you'll find that this is easier with putdocx text block commands. These were introduced in Stata 16. Simply enclose your text between a putdocx text block begin and putdocx text block end command. So here I say, we have data on birth weights from Hosmer, Lemeshow, and Sturdivant. This data set includes some demographic information on each infant's mother, such as her age and race, and so on. Next, I want to include summary statistics. Here I note the total number of infants and their average birth weight. First, I summarize the birth weight variable BWT, and then I refer to the returned results using the DD.docx display tag. This tag executes the display command and replaces the tag with the output. So this is how you can refer to returned results in your text. Next, I want to note how many mothers smoked during pregnancy and how many didn't. So first I store the total number of observations in the macro total. Then I count the number of mothers who smoke, and the count command will store this in the R class scalar n. So I simply subtract this from the macro total to get the number of mothers who don't smoke. Note that here I am appending this block of text to the active paragraph by using putdocx text block append instead of begin. Next, I graph the mean birth weight for babies with mothers who smoke versus those who do not, separately for mothers with and without a history of hypertension. And to include this graph in the Word document, I need to convert it to one of the supported image formats. Here, I use graph export to convert it to a PNG file. To include an image, we need to append it to a paragraph. So here you see the putdocx paragraph and putdocx image commands. By now, you've probably noticed that the putdocx commands are intuitive. The command is putdocx followed by the item you are exporting, putdocx text, putdocx image, and so on. After the image, I add some text describing the model I'm going to fit below. The last thing I'll include in this report is a table of regression results. I've used the C format option to format the coefficients, standard errors, and confidence limits to two decimal places. After fitting a model with one of the supported estimation commands, simply type putdocx table, a table name, and then etable to export the table of estimation results. You can also use this syntax after a margins or estimates table command. Here I've also added a title to this table. With the last putdocx text block commands, I add a brief comment on the regression results. Now that I am done exporting content to this document, I save it as bwreport.docx, and I can run this do file to create this document. Let's customize this document. We can add section headings for the summary statistics and regression results, and we can modify the size of the graph. We can also drop this row from the table and shade in alternating rows. Another feature introduced in Stata 16 was the capability to add headers and footers with page numbers. So let's do that now with the following do file. This is a modified version of our previous do file. Here, we created a document with a footer, and then we defined the content of the footer. You'll note that we included page numbers in the footer as well. And we inserted a page break after the title. Then we added headings for each new section of the document, one for the data, summary statistics, and regression results. Everything else stayed the same, but here we specify the height and the width of the image. Then we drop the third row of the table with the drop option. We specify the column index as a decimal. And then we add a light gray background to all the columns of rows 2 and 4. Let's run this to file to see our updated report. Here you can see the page numbers in the footer. In fact, we could include chapter numbers as well. Suppose each of these sections is going to be a chapter in our report. We can modify our last to file by telling Stata which style we use for the chapter headings. So in this to file, we specify that we used heading 1 and that we want a colon to separate the chapter and page numbers. We also remove the text page from the footer because now we'll be including chapter numbers as well. Let's run this to file and take a look at the resulting document. Right now we only see page numbers, so what we need to do is select a multi-level list that includes the heading style we used. So I'll select this multi-level list right here, and as soon as I do that, you'll see that we are currently on chapter 2, page 2. Now let's say you are building a report in pieces. You can specify how the header, footer, page numbers, and page breaks will appear in the appended document. For example, I have created a list of references for this report in Word and saved it as references.docx. Note that this file has a footer. Let's append this file to the BW report file by typing the following. This will append the references file to the BW report file, beginning on a new page, and the resulting document will be saved as report.docx. Here is the resulting document. Note that the footer from the first document was applied all throughout the document. This is the default behavior. But we can instead specify that each document use its own header and footer by typing the following. Here we're replacing the report file. The head source option specifies the document from which headers and footers are to be used. You can specify first, last, or own for the source of the header. And because we want the page numbering to start over on the first page of the references file, we also add the option Page Num Restart. Here is the resulting document. Here you can see how the references file retained its own footer. And if I add a table of contents, all these headings will be included. So this is how you can create reproducible and customized Word documents with Stata results and graphs. There is a lot more you can do. You can customize the font, create tables from the dataset in memory or from matrices, and even embed images within a table. And you can organize your document into sections, each with their own layout. If you would like to learn more about creating customized Word documents with Stata results and graphs, you can download the reporting reference manual from our website at stata.com. Thank you for watching.